world once a year. All birds do, but they replace the feathers a few at a time over a couple of months, so that by late spring, she'll have all of her brand new feathers for the year. Absolutely, yeah, no problem. Now, if you're looking at her, you'll notice that, you know, wow, they say, well, people are so amazed at how far they can turn their necks around, but their eyes are fixed in the socket. They can't move their eyes around the way we can. And so to get, you know, more peripheral vision, they've got to turn their head. Their eyes are so large, what you're seeing is only about half the size of it, what's compared to the size that's actually in the skull. So
say a large man's fist clenched up, that's about how big her body is. Her legs are half of that. So her body comes down to about here, the rest of that is legs that are all tucked in underneath.
You can bury your finger right in, work like a ratchet, and that they'll lock. So even with my hands, I couldn't pry her feet open to get that out without a lot of difficulty. Until she decides to let go.
Mind you, as an example, you can see with her body and her legs, those proportions. To help get that under fluff.
So will they appear a little less fluffy and chubby in the summer?
She looks pretty much the same. It's all that under fluff.
Oh, okay.
So her outer feathers are still going to be the same, but she'll have less density of under feathers. And this throat is also what she uses for when she fills with the air, and that what's gives her sound. She'll do that. She uses the, you see it.
So she does not actually get those hooting calls?
Yes.
Yeah.
So she'll do it because she'll be hearing to who she thinks is her mate as humans.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. If you were to put a male great horn in her pen, she would look at it like, what the heck are you doing here? Yeah.
No, I didn't. Is it possible to do that one more time?
That's making her uncomfortable.
Okay.
You keep seeing that camera, don't you?